It's a lovely sunny day here, day 7 of the Gwangju 28th Summer University Games. We will head to that very same stadium. This is the men's 10,000 meters on the docket today, as well as women's discus. We're back at the pool for last night's medal-winning performances. We have women's and men's team table tennis semifinal contests. 4 medals handed out in Taekwondo last night. And women's football semifinals featuring Russia and Canada. As well, we'll head to the shooting range for the 10-meter pistol team competition. Heading back to day 6 for athletics. What you see inside the Gwangju Universiade main stadium. The men's 10,000 meters. And there you get the full start list. And they will head off a 10-kilometer race for gold. And pulling away into the final turn, that's Igor Maximov, competitor 828 of Russia. And he will pull away, you can see here, to win in a time of 29.15.30 seconds. Second place goes to Nicolae Alexandru Soare of Romania. He ran a personal best of 29 minutes, 18.71 seconds. And there you get a look at Nawasenge Mudiyanselage of Sri Lanka, barefooted runner. He thought he was done. He still has one lap to go, and he heads off again. But there you have the final results. Maximov, Soare, and Nakatini with bronze. Now the women's discus. There are the competitors from yesterday. Here is Yulia Maltseva of Russia. This is her second attempt. She threw 56.54 on her first. And with this, she will throw 59.37 meters. Now we look at Marika Steinacker of Germany. Her sixth attempt, her best so far, 58.13 meters on her first throw. And she will better that here. A great throw, 58.83 meters. You get a look at the strength and the footwork there from Steinacker. She's really happy with that throw on her final attempt. Now Stefania Strumilo of Italy. This is her fifth. So far her top throw, 56.06 meters. And for her, that will be a personal best, 58.22, and that'll be enough to land her in third spot, a bronze medal for Strumilo. Steinacker of Germany will win the silver, and Yulia Maltseva of Russia, with a throw of 59.37 meters, wins the gold medal in women's discus. Now women's pole vault. Here is the start list. First up, we'll take a look at Chloé Henry of Belgium. She's originally a gymnast and actually competed at one world championship before injuring herself and turning her attention to pole vault. Now holds the Belgian indoor and outdoor record. Now Eliza McCartney of New Zealand. And a great vault for her. She's happy with that one. That would be at 4.35 meters. Now this is Lee at 4.40, and she will clear to keep pace with the Belgian and the Kiwi. Next up, we're back to McCartney. This at 4.40. Good look at it there, and a great vault. She's ecstatic about that one. She equals that 4.40 mark Lee set. Now Henri. She couldn't clear in her first two attempts at 4.40 meters. Can she do it here? And she does. She will clear there, but that would be as high as she and McCartney would go. Li Ling will clear at 4.45 meters to win gold, McCartney silver, and Henri the bronze. Last night's swimming action. First up, we will look at the women's 200 meter freestyle. You get a look inside the NAMBU University Aquatic Center. In lane five, Shannon Vreeland, three gold medals already here at Universiade, looking for her fourth. In lane three, Martina De Mem of Italy, she won a bronze already here in the 400 meters and won 400 meter gold back in 2013. But there you see Vreeland pulling away again. Can she get her fourth gold medal of the games? And she does. Shannon Vreeland, an unbelievable performance here in Guangzhou. A time of 1 minute 58.38 seconds, just ahead of Wang Shijia of China and De Mem of Italy.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Now on to the men's 200 meter backstroke final. In lane four, there you see Jacob Pebley of the United States won a bronze in both the 100 meter and 200 meter backstroke back in Kazan in 2013. Lane three, Keita Tsunami of Japan won a bronze in the 200 meter individual medley earlier here at Guangzhou. And there is Pebley. He will add a gold medal to his collection in a time of 1 minute 56.29 seconds. Tsunami second, Shabasov third, and Chicharitze of Italy, who won silver in the 100 meter backstroke already here at Universiade, he finishes fourth. A sprint now, the men's 50 meter breaststroke.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome
lane five, Chaba Silagyi of Serbia, competed at the 2012 Olympics. And in lane six, Dmitry Balandin, he won the 100 meter breaststroke here at Guangzhou and was triple gold in the 50, 100, and 200 meter breaststroke at last year's Asian Games. Not to be counted out is Andrea Toniato of Italy. He set a Universiade record on day five in this event in qualification. Also, that was a new Italian record. And as they come to the wall, very close, Silagyi of Serbia wins the gold medal, just ahead of the Universiade record holder Toniato. And Dmitry Balandin wins his second medal here in Korea, a bronze in the men's 50-meter breaststroke. And the final event from last night, the men's 4x200 meter relay. In the freestyle relay back in Kazan, Russia won gold, United States silver, and Australia the bronze. Michael Winalda for the U.S. was on that 2013 team, and he's swimming here for the Americans as well. And there you see a close-up of the United States making their way to the wall. Well out in front, that's Kyle Whitaker, and he will bring it home for the United States gold medal in the 4x200 meter freestyle relay. Australia will win the silver, and Japan a bronze medal. There you get a close-up of Whitaker. Time of 7 minutes, 10.82 seconds. Good enough for a gold here for the U.S. And there you get the final results. And all the medalists together, U.S., Australia, and Japan, here last night at swimming.
Thank you.
From the Jiangxiang Hongildong Gymnasium here outside of Guangzhou, this is women's team table tennis, a semifinal featuring Chinese Taipei and Korea. Chinese Taipei won silver in this event in 2013 in Kazan. They also won bronze back in Shenzhen in 2011. This is the final of five matches, currently tied two apiece. And this is Chiang Yi-Ching of Chinese Taipei and Jeon Ji-hee of Korea. We're in the third game. Currently, Chiang leading 8-6. She also won the first two.
Game one, 14-12, and game two, 11-9. The winner of this heads off to the gold medal match to face China. Here's Gian serving. And a nice forehand winner there for her. Now 8-7. Get a good replay here. There's that forehand. Chang just can't catch up to it. 9-7 now, Chang leading. And that one will be off the side of the table and out point to Chang. Now one away from sending her team to the gold medal match. She gets set to serve. And that one will go wide. Chinese Taipei wins 3-2 over Korea. They will now head to the gold medal match to take on China. There you see the full results. And Korea will now take on Japan for bronze. Over now to the men's team semifinal. This is France and China. China won the gold in this event back in Kazan in 2013. And Liu Yi is back from that team. He also won gold in the men's singles in Kazan. He won his match earlier 3-0. This match features Fang Yinqi of China and Romain Laurence of France. Laurence was at Universiade in Kazan. He won a bronze medal in the men's doubles. This is game four here between these two. Fang won the first game 11-9. Laurence came back and won the second 11-6. Fang won the third 11-8, and we're now tied at 7 here in the fourth. A nice backhand there as Laurence got a little bit back on his heels and couldn't get over there to push it back across the table.
8-7.
Fang to serve, up one. So we'll put that one off the top of the net and out. China now 2 points away from the gold medal match. And that's a let, so Laurence will reserve. And that one just sails wide for Laurence. We are now at match point. And that one just falls short for Laurence, and France will do the same as they fall here to China, 3-0. China to face Japan in the gold medal match, while France will take on Chinese Taipei in the bronze. Taekwondo from the Chosun University Gymnasium here in Gwangju. We'll start with the women's under 57 kilo class. This features Kim So-hee of Korea. She's in the red. And Joanna Da Silva Cunha of Portugal. She is in the blue. Cunha won the European Junior Championships in 2014. While Kim won a bronze at Universiade in Shenzhen in 2011 and was also world champion in 2013. Currently 3-0 for Kim. Cunha trying to get back into it. Having a tough time against this Korean opponent. And she won't be able to do it. 6-0. Kim wins gold. Kuna of Portugal, silver. Nisaisam of Thailand and Glasnovic of Sweden each win bronze. Moving on now to the women's under 46 kilo class, Lin Wan-ting of Chinese Taipei up against Willisini Kamsrubusa of Thailand. Lin is in red, as you see there. Kamsrubusa in blue. Lin won bronze at this year's World Championships. And Kamsrubusa had success here in Korea last year at the Korean Open, finishing third in Gyeongju. No score up until that point, as Lin will count one, and that is all she'll need. Lin Wan-ting of Chinese Taipei, the gold medalist in the women's under 46 kilo class. Kamsrubusa silver, Yu of Korea, and Katuki of Cyprus each take a bronze medal home. Men's under 68 kilo class. Berke Akyol of Turkey up against Ryu Dae-han of Korea. Ryu won the Korean Open last year in this class, while Akyol in 2013 won the European Championships and was second at the European Junior Championships. Good battle here. Points scored there for Akyol. Ryu trying to find a way to attack up against the Turk, but having a difficult time. Time starts to wind down here on the Korean, and there it does. Berke Akyol, gold medalist in the men's under 68 kilo class. Ryu is disconsolate on the floor. He will win silver. Joel Gonzalez of Spain and Christian McNeish of Great Britain each take bronze. Now the final bout from yesterday. In blue, it's Segalani Hadapur of Iran. And in red, it's Murat Lakraoui of Belgium. Hadapur won the Dutch Open last year, and Lakraoui was third in that same event. There are the Iranian fans supporting Hadapur. 1-0 right now, he leads. And he will score three right there to move up 4-0. Lakraoui trying to get back here. Scores one, down 4-1. But time runs out on the Belgian. Hadapur of Iran will win gold. Lakraoui of Belgium, the silver. Kim of Korea and Ten of Russia each win bronze. It is women's semifinal football time. The Boseong Public Stadium, the site for Russia taking on Canada. Canada in its first football semifinal here at Universiade since 1991. They beat the Czechs 2-1 in their quarterfinal, while Russia defeated Brazil 1-0 in theirs. Here's a great chance for Russia. That's Chernomyrdina off the bar. You'll see right there. Can't quite beat Marie-Joëlle Vandal of Canada. Now in the 20th minute, a stop there by Vandal. And again here, another one blocked by Canada. Here you see that initial great save. Russia again with the pressure. Another stop, but that one stays in play, and that is Pantyukina. She will knock it home off the initial shot from Choloviaga. And Russia, in the 32nd minute, has a 1-0 lead. Now in stoppage time here in the first half. And here is Tarakova, some nice footwork, but that one just sails wide. At half, it will be 1-0 Russia in front. Now in the second half, Choloviaga to the wide side of the field. And that is Tarakova. And from here, she will go to work.
gets right to the middle of the box. And with that left-footed boot, fires it home. Russia up 2-0. Great play there by Elena Terekova. You'll get a good look at it here on the replay. She just cuts inside the Canadian defender and gets a great shot past Van Dahl. Canada trying to find a way to stay in this. But a turnover here, the initial save by Van Dahl, but a nice chip there. And that'll be Terekova's second goal of the match. Here in the 65th minute, 3-0, the Russians in front of Canada. There you see the nice play by Chernomyrdina with the initial steal and the beautiful soft chip by Russia. And Terekova has two goals here on this afternoon. Now in the 77th minute. Some great work here by Choliviaga, and she will ultimately put that ball past Van Dahl. 4-0, the Russians in command. And you'll see just great work, great effort there by Choliviaga. Able to slip it past Van Dahl. You do see a little bit of a tip there that caused some challenge for the Canadian keeper. At the end, 4-0, Russia moves on to the gold medal final. They will face either Japan or France, while Canada will take on the loser from that other semifinal. From the Nanju Jilinamdo shooting range in Gwangju, this is the men's 10-meter air pistol team competition. And there you see the start list. Various medalists from other shooting competitions so far here at Universiad featured in this competition today. And there you get a look at Park Dae-hoon of Korea. He won a gold medal earlier on in the 50-meter pistol. And you get a close-up of his scoreboard. Wide look at what the spectators get to see here at Nanju Jilinamdo. Also featured here from Mongolia, who in a bronze medalist from the 50-meter pistol team, that would be Dayaku Engtaivan. And he would go on to have a good performance here today as well. Wang Jiwei of China, another favored competitor, former Olympic medalist, and multiple medalists so far here at Universiad. The French team, another one to be looked at. They won gold in the team competition in the 25-meter standard pistol. But there you have the final results. Korea first, Mongolia second, and Russia wins a bronze medal.
넌 허리가 몇이니?
24요.
힙은?
34요.
어렸을 때부터 난 눈이 좀 달라 아무리 예뻐도 뒤에 살이 모자라면 난 눈이 안 가 흰색 머리에 바람이 불면 날아갈 것 같이 가냅한 여자라면 난 맘이 안 가 허리는 너무 가는데 힙이 커 맞는 바지를 찍기 너무 힘들어 Oh yeah Booty that booty booty Shake that booty that booty booty 앞에서 바라보면 너무 착한데 뒤에서 바라보면 미치겠어 Oh yeah Booty that booty booty Shake that booty that booty booty 널 어쩌면 좋니